Hello again and welcome to another Contacts with Conway. My name is Martin Conway and in this edition I continue my conversation with Pat Caroline from Pacific University. We start the conversation by looking at the non-wetting issues associated with high decay gas permeable materials. And then we move on to the possible use of tangible hydropeg surface treatment for those materials. If you would prefer to watch this video with subtitles, please click on the cog in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen and select your preferred language.
You know, most of these lenses at the moment, I can't remember what the scope study was, it's somewhere like 64% or 74%, I think, are going on to irregular corneas. Mm-hmm. Obviously, a lot of these keratoconics have dry eye issues along with their main problem, which is the keratoconus. How are you dealing with non-wetting of these materials, and have the materials improved since we first started looking at them 10 years ago?
Yeah, you know, I've got to admit, when we first started working with the higher decay lens materials, wetting was a pretty significant issue, and I don't want to trivialize it. You know, we still have individual patients with issues, but you know, one of the things that we have now that we didn't have then was, you know, we've got the tangible hydropeg system. And in certain individuals, it has really been a game changer. It's been a lifesaver for some of these patients. Mm-hmm. Now, of course, the question that's always asked is, how long does it last? And I think the best way I've dealt with that is the fact that it lasts long enough. And what I mean by long enough, it's almost like once a patient has been wearing a lens for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 months, their own, you know, personal biofilm gets covered across that lens. And once that happens, we have oftentimes improved wetting properties. So I think the hydropeg lasts long enough right. That it allows the patient's own biofilm to kind of take over. And once that's in place, our wetting issues are surprisingly minimal today compared to what they were 5 or 6 years ago.
And what sort of percentage of patients are you actually applying the hydropeg treatment to?
I think we routinely do it on all of our patients with ocular surface disease that we're placing into scleral lenses. But we don't use it routinely. Just on that population, we routinely do it. But on our keratoconics, on our post-corneal transplant patients, it's kind of a wait-and-see situation. Do we have some wetting issues that need to be addressed? It does seem to be a very, very individual phenomenon.
We took a brief break at that point, and we now rejoin the conversation as we start to discuss the introduction of a new material from Contamat called Optimum Infinite.
You know, following our work at Pacific on the high decay materials, we went on to develop the hyper decay material that we now call Optimum Infinite. And I just wonder whether you could share with us any of your experience with it so far.
Yeah, we've done quite a bit of work with the Infinite material in the fact that, you know, our primary concern was, were we going to be able to have reasonable wetting properties? And got to admit, the Infinite wetted very, very well for our patients. And there was this cohort of individuals that really benefited from the higher decay, and that's those following penetrating keratoplasty. our clinical experience has shown us that individuals with normal functioning endothelium, surface disease patients, keratoconics, and so on, they seem to do well with any material with a decay of 100 or greater. But it's those individuals with compromised endothelium, the post-penetrating keratoplasty patients, that have always required that extra level of permeability. And that's what we get with the infinite material. We get the added oxygen permeability without losing any of the other performance properties in the scleral lens.
So you're using it principally as a problem solver for the
right now. That is the truth. We are using it primarily as a problem solver, but as with many of our problem solvers, they eventually evolve into our primary material of choice. And if the infinite continues to perform like it does, I think we're going to see ourselves evolving in that direction.
Well, that's good to hear. I'll pass it on to the guys that developed it. They'll be, receive your feedback.
You bet.
I mean, we did develop it with the aim of boosting the decay above and beyond what was available on the market to date. But also not to require any additional surface treatment in the lab. And the other thing we built into it, we hoped, was the fact that it withstood handling better. I mean, some of these hyper decay materials have been very prone to scratching. And and the feedback we've had is that, it stands up to patients' handling over the period. And also within the lab, obviously, with some of its predecessors, materials of this range, in this range of hyper decay levels, it was very difficult to get them through the lab even in one piece. They required extra special handling, and this we hear it doesn't appear to have that issue. But thanks very much for your feedback on that, pal. I'll certainly
pass it
to the guys in the lab.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much for your attention once more. If you've enjoyed these conversations, please remember to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.